Hello and welcome to another Roblox tutorial. In this video, I will be showing you a few ways to destroy parts using scripting in Roblox Studio. This is a very simple video, so Roblox programmers of all types can tune in and learn a little bit from this. So I hope you guys enjoy. Make sure to like and subscribe if you do, and let's get right into it. So I have my part in front of me with a script parented to it. I'm going to go into my script and first define my part, which is going to be equal to script.parent. And then I'm going to call part destroy. So this function destroys the part in the most basic way possible. The one problem with it is that if I were to call workspace.part destroy after I already destroy it, it will error because, first of all, it can't find the part, and second of all, even when you're just finding it normally, you still won't be able to destroy it and your script will error. But that's the most basic way to destroy a part. So the next way we're going to destroy our part is I'm going to go back to my scripts, clear this, and we're just going to set part.parent equal to nil. So if we were to run this, you see that the part disappears as it were destroyed. This is the same, does the same thing as part destroy, but it's just a different way to do it. And now, let's do another way. I'm going to define the debris service, which is going to be equal to game get service debris. And then I'm going to call debris, add item, part, and then one. So what this does is this basically says it waits a second and then checks to see if part exists and then destroys it. So if I were to run this, you see it waits a second and it destroys the part. So the benefit of using a function like this is if I were to say print hi, the print occurs instantly. The script is not yielded, it's not stopped by this line right here. And instead of saying wait one, then part destroy, that would error, like depending on the situation you have. But with this service, it automatically checks for the part and does everything you would expect it to do. So it's very nice. I use this a lot for things that are debris, such as balls or projectiles or projections and stuff like that. So yeah. And that's about all of the ways you can destroy a part using scripting in Roblox Studio. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was very quick, a little different style of video. Make sure to comment your suggestions and observations down below. But make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed. I hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.